48 hours later, and we still don't have many answers in our now infamous democracy debacle. But Melissa Blasius has been looking into this. Melissa, what can you share at this point?
Well, while you can't stop or take back Tuesday's fiasco, you certainly can prevent it from happening again. So while they're counting ballots here in this room from Tuesday's election still, elected officials in our county and across the state are talking about investigations and reform plans. First, we have another special election coming up in less than 2 months on two statewide propositions. Maricopa County Recorder Helen Purcell says she's already working to double the number of polling places from 60, which definitely wasn't enough on Tuesday, to about 120. Republican state lawmaker Kimberly Yee is spearheading an election reform bill to put in state law a minimum number of polling places that you could have in our two biggest counties. That's Maricopa and Pima. Finally, Democratic Party leaders are all fired up. They've heard from thousands of angry voters already, and they're looking at whether there were any violations of people's voting rights, whether intentional or unintentional.
Sitting and standing in 4 to 5 hours to vote, even if you end up voting, is still voter suppression. And the fact that people are now questioning whether or not their vote is counted at all also is voter suppression.
State Democratic Party leaders say they are going to kind of look for a few more days at what they found out from what they've heard from voters, and then they may take their findings to the Justice Department asking for more investigation, or they may use their findings as a basis of a lawsuit. They haven't made any final decisions on that, and they expect to do that sometime next week. Coming up at 5, you will hear directly from Helen Purcell about the very latest in all of this, as well as we have numbers of the number of voters who turned out at polling places on Tuesday, and they may surprise you how few people were actually there. Back to you.